AI is already a huge part of our lives today. We should be skilling ourselves up to be working alongside the machines so they get the best of human intelligence working alongside the best of artificial intelligence. I see AI as like a foundational technology that pretty much underpins every technological advancement that we're looking at today, from genetic sequencing to the deployments of satellites in low Earth orbit, to the underpinnings of the private space industry, to diagnostics in hospitals, to powering the autonomous vehicle. Pretty much every single part of our life in the next 5, 10, 15 years will be touched by AI, and we're even starting to see that happening today. I also see AI a bit like a commodity, a bit like electricity or water or Wi-Fi. The sort of thing that we would stream as a business or as a government or as a household in the same way that we might stream those other commodities, streaming intelligence or IQ and pointing that at whatever problems or things that we need to solve in our business or in our life. I'm excited about AI because it has this incredible ability to learn incredibly fast. AI, unlike us and our sort of small, wet, organic brains, has the ability to scale incredibly quickly. And not only does it scale quickly, it learns very quickly. It evolves very much like we've evolved over the last 50,000 years or so from the sort of savannah until today, in the sense that it gets released into an environment, whether that's the trading floor or a set of diagnostics or, as I said, the autonomous vehicle. And it learns, survives, dies, thrives in exactly the evolutionary way that we have done, as I said, over the last sort of 50,000 years or so. We're not going to have to give machines explicit commands. They will instead be powered by this artificial intelligence that has infiltrated our environment and be able to be predictive about the kinds of things, the Uber that we might want, or the Google Play video that we want to watch, or the Amazon item that we need to order, and instead become a much smarter environment as opposed to being very specific to each of our devices. We're going to be talking to the internet, and almost, I should think, in a few years, think it was funny that we ever typed or ever didn't converse with machines. What I'm interested in actually is emotion recognition, is these platforms where the robots or our devices will be able to use our micro expressions that kind of ripple across our face as we're making decisions, or indeed our heart rate or any other indicators of our emotional state, and use that to converse with us. And I think that will make the kind of communication with the machines, as it were, as a much more intuitive and human experience, and hopefully take our eyes off whatever device that we have been staring at for the last sort of 10 or 15 years. We can expect that every aspect of our life will be monitored primarily to give us better services, but obviously there is an underbelly, there's a risk involved with a lot of that that some people might feel particularly concerned about. Some people say that artificial intelligence could be the last invention that we ever make. Some people call it an existential risk, a risk to the future of our species. Peter Thiel puts this very nicely when he talks about it in terms of aliens. He said, if aliens were to land on the planet tomorrow, would you ask them, I wonder if this alien is going to take my job? No, you would worry whether they were friendly or unfriendly. And I think we need to think about artificial intelligence in those same terms. Of course, it's important to discuss the impact of artificial intelligence on our economy, but it is just as important for us to have many other parallel discussions about the impact that it'll have on all aspects of our lives. We're living in an era of big data. At every aspect of every part of our life, we're spewing out all kinds of different information from lots of different sensors, whether that's in low Earth orbit, from satellites to drones, monitoring activity, perhaps in agriculture, all the way down to something as small as this, which is a genetic sequencer, something that would have been the size of a cathedral a few years ago that's now the size of a Mars bar. And this is a very exciting thing, but it does give us huge challenges when it comes to managing that kind of data. If I can use this to sequence any biological information that I come across on a daily basis, that's very exciting, but I'm going to be overwhelmed by the information that comes out of that. I'm going to need some pretty smart AI to help me derive some useful benefit or insights from these kind of new devices. Because of the explosion in artificial intelligence, in data, and of course the acceleration of computing power, we're suddenly going to be able to have access to an incredible amount of information and be able to ask all kinds of new questions that we've never been able to ask before.